It's really weird how y'all keep on popping up in here like this. Like, do y'all pop up when I'm showering and stuff too? Because I think that's really weird. Like, you just keep popping up in here on me like that. Like, it's weird. Oh, I like this light better. But yeah, like, it's weird. Y'all need to stop being weird, bro. Stop it. Stop being weird. Like, at least let me know you come before you come so I can prepare. It's crazy. It's crazy. But since y'all here, might as well. What's up, YouTube? It's your girl, Denisha, back with another fantastic video. So, guys, guess what day it is? Monday, which means it is Military Monday. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. First off, if you are new here, go on ahead and hit that subscribe button, and I want to welcome you to my channel. And if you're an original, welcome back. So, this video, I'm not gonna talk about basic training or nothing like that. I'm just gonna reflect. You feel me? I'm gonna reflect. And I'm gonna tell y'all why I'm gonna reflect in a minute. You feel me? But yeah, go ahead and sit back, relax, take your shoes off, get comfortable since y'all already here. But yeah, let's get to it.
No apologies for being find me where the wild.
So this month I actually made 3 years in the Air Force. Okay. Thank you. So this video, I'm just gonna reflect a little bit, not too much, on the entire 3 years that I've been in. First, I want to say that I really joined off a leap of faith, because when I tell y'all I had never thought about, dreamed about, considered anything with the military. I had never thought about it. But one day I was just like in a dark space in my life, and I was just like, I need to get away. So went and got a recruiter from all different branches and took the ASVAB, got into the Air Force, and it just went from there. So basic training really was a great experience. Like, you learned a lot. Personally, myself, I don't think I really did the most growing in basic training, because when I left, I kind of feel like I was still myself a little bit. Like, I had chilled a little on laughing and stuff like that, but for the most part, I think I was still myself. So when I was in basic training, I really was trying to let go and free myself of a lot of stuff that I was going through, and that's what I used the time for. Like, a lot of people that was in my flight, like, they tell me that they grew in basic training, like, they saw a side of themselves that they never saw, but my focus was to let go. And when I tell y'all that's what I did. Tech school, like, it probably was like one of the best parts of my military career so far, because I met friends or best friends. Like, they like my sisters. We met in basic training. We was in the same flight, but then we was in the same flight for tech school too. So it kind of made our bond a little stronger, a lot stronger, because like, we went through everything, literally everything together. And we really made a lot of memories there, like a lot of memories. That was my first time actually getting attached to a person and then having to be separated by the military. So it was like a growing experience there, because like, I was used to being with them pretty much all day, every day. And then we all got stationed literally in different places. Like, we literally in different places, thousands of miles apart from each other, but we still talk all the time. Like, I feel like even though I'm not with them, I don't miss a beat with nothing that they have going on. My first duty station, like, I came here too a lot. I dealt with, like, racial situations, people talking to me based off, like, because I'm this rank, I can talk to you this way, like, getting in trouble for my mouth. Like, it really has been a growing experience here. Like, I have grown the most here. Like, I've learned that every action doesn't need a reaction. Like, just because somebody say something to me don't mean I have to react to it. Because before, I was quick on reacting. Like, you're not finna talk to me no type of way. I don't care who you are. Like, I don't care. When I first got here, that was still my mindset. But then I learned that it take a lot of energy to feed into stuff like that. And misery loves company. So, like, if you have higher NCOs, senior NCOs that's miserable, then 9 times out of 10, it's a domino effect. Like, if they come to work miserable, they gonna make you miserable. And I've learned that, yes, that's gonna happen, but I have to control the way I think. Like, only I have control over that. So, like, I've learned a lot, like, a lot about the military here, a lot about myself here. Like, and I'm still learning. Like, I am still learning. Three of my favorite military memories. One would be tech school for sure. Two would be honor guard. I did honor guard here on the base honor guard. And three, basic training would have to be in my top three too, because that was really, like, you made a lot of memories in basic training. So yeah, three of the hardest things that I've dealt with was, one, adapting to new people, because, like, it's a lot of different ethnicities and everything in the military. So it was really hard to adapt, like, my lifestyle to other people's lifestyles. But you also, like, grow a lot when you learn and hang around other types of people. So I would say that would be one. Two would be dealing with racial issues. Like, it's, that probably is one thing that I'm still, you'll never fully learn how to deal with that kind of stuff. Like, I've had somebody tell me, I need to stop acting like I work at Walmart. And I'm just like, what does that even mean? Like, can you elaborate? Tell me what that means. Stop acting like I work at Walmart. Like, what? I feel like that's like telling somebody you need to stop acting like you work at McDonald's. Like, how do you, what? Make it make sense. And the food here, like, the food on our base is trash. So, like, transitioning from basic training food to tech school food to here, listen, basic training had the best food that I've had so far in the military. Tech school food, trash. Here, trash. Like, I love food, so that's why I would say that was probably one of the hardest things for me, because I like to eat. And there's not really nothing in this area to eat, like, nothing. What else can I reflect on? On a positive note, like, you really meet some great people in the military. Like, the type of friends you have in the military and the type of friends you have, like, in the regular civilian world are two different types of friends. Like, it's not even on the same level. Like, because it's like when you hear, when you're all away from, like, family, and y'all know that y'all really all y'all have, you tend to look out for the people that you care about more versus being home and being around like everybody that you used to. Because honestly, I feel like I've met my best, greatest friends in the military. Like, don't get me wrong, I have some friends from back home that I'm like still close with, still cool with, but my best, greatest friends have come from the military. But it's kind of like a scary situation, like, because you don't know, like, you really could wake up the next day and then the military could be tearing y'all apart. Like, you can be stationed in Florida and then they can get stationed all the way in Korea. And it's like, dang, now you got to start over pretty much again. But honestly, if I could change, would I change being in the military? No. Because, like, personally, I have learned a lot about myself. I've grown a lot. And it's just like, it's a different type of feeling knowing that, like, okay, I did that. Like, I've grown as a person. I have people that look up to me and proud of me and enjoy seeing me do what I do. Like, that's really a good feeling. So I will say this, the military is not for everybody. Like, it's not for everybody. So don't think just because I'm saying that I wouldn't change being in the military, you should go join, because it's not for everybody. Everybody that joined don't stay in. Everybody that was in my basic training flight did not graduate basic training. Some of them could not deal with being away from family. And I really think that's one of the hardest parts. You miss birthdays, you miss holidays. Like, you miss a lot. Weddings, you miss a lot. So, and personally, I feel like when I'm here, I miss out on a lot that's going on back home. Like, people done got married. They didn't give me invites to weddings because, like, I'm here, they there. But it's really, I don't know. Like, it's weird, you know? But at the end of the day, like, you got to do what's best for you. Stuff like that hurt, true enough, but it's still a learning experience. Because nine times I feel like military friends and civilian friends, like, you meet family in the military. Like, for real, you meet family. But greatest highlight of the military would be meeting the people that I've met. To make a long story short, to put it in a nutshell, that would be my greatest highlight so far. Mind you, again, I only been in 3 years, so I can't really say. But yeah, like, so yeah, this was just pretty much a reflection video. I could go on and 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 on, but I ain't gonna do that because I want to keep this video kind of short and sweet, you know. If y'all have any questions about the military, feel free to drop them in the comments. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, like, comment on this video, turn on post notifications so you'll be notified every time I post a new video. That's all I have for this one, y'all. I hope y'all all have a great week. Be blessed, never stressed, and we out.